Welcome, welcome. Roger Fernandez is our guest, and we're talking about the Borinqueneers, or what are you, you're going to tell us the unit, the 65th artillery unit of the United States Army that I was part of and has been in the news recently involving President Obama, and a great story to tell. And it's Roger Hernandez, a great friend, and welcome so much to Conversations.
Thank you, Howard. The way that you pronounce the name of the 65th Infantry Regiment is the Borinqueneers.
Say it again.
Borinqueneers.
Borinqueneers, yeah. Right. And that is because the name of the original name of the island of Puerto Rico, which they were a part of,
right,
is what?
Well, during the transport of the troops from Puerto Rico to Korea, mm-hmm, to fight and engage, they were called up for duty, the Korean War in 1950.
Uh-huh.
They got together and sought a battle name.
Uh-huh.
And they put together the essence of their pride and their valor and their courage to the Borinqueneers. And it's named after the Indian tribe of Puerto Rico.
The Taino, is that?
No.
Yeah.
The Borinquas.
Borinquas.
And W.W. Harris, the commanding colonel of the unit, uh-huh, says on page 48,
mm-hmm,
that many of the men were actually direct descendants of that proud, industrious race of Indian people.
And you are a member of that group as well.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
You're a descendant and you're...
Roberto Borrero, yeah. Mucado, as everybody here in New York knows. He's the president of the United Confederation of Taino people. We have a website, www.uctp.org.
And there's a lot of action going on at the UN to represent the indigenous peoples of the New World, is there
yeah,
not?
The yeah, New World and throughout the world, because they're indigenous
the
people from the top of Alaska to the tip. It's all a matter of perspective.
You're right. Now, what we're talking about is a unit, right?
The United States came in and claimed Puerto Rico as part of war booty against the Spaniards.
Right.
And we were thrown in the mix.
Mm-hmm.
There wasn't any Puerto Rican that I have ever heard of that asked to be American. But the Treaty of Paris in 1917 made us overnight American citizens.
Yeah, it was coming on.
And as an American citizen, you get drafted.
Uh-huh.
And that was part of the reason why Puerto Rico was incorporated as a territory. Or a colony, C-O-L-O-N-Y, colony of United States of America.
I thought they had a unique thing. It was more like a commonwealth status.
No, that's bullshit.
Is that bullshit, really? Is it really?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, really? It's not? It is, right?
Everybody knows that, Harold, except for you. But that's okay because the United States is very effective in just sucking out the mental prowess of anybody or anything. And if you believe what you read, and if you don't research what you hear,
mm-hmm,
well, you're going to end up being a dumb American.
Well, yeah, a lot of us, I guess, in certain like
that. We all are. I mean, if you pay attention to what these guys are putting out.
But they had a division or a regiment or something that was all Puerto Rican.
So they all of us overnight. Puerto Ricans became American citizens and they got drafted for the First World War, the Second World War, the Korean War, the Vietnam War, the Iraqi War. You name it, there's always been a war here in the United States of America, and they need draftees.
And the 65th Regiment, is that what it is? The unit that we're talking about was unique, and that's the one that they're talking about in this book, and that's the one that was just celebrated by President Obama in a major kind of way, giving it the gold medal or something like
that. Well, the Korean...
It was a major development in terms of the Puerto Rican community here in New York or around the world.
Well, for us Puerto Ricans, it's a real big deal. The interesting thing about the Korean War is that it was not even really designated as a war. It was a conflict.
Yeah, I know. It was unique. Yeah, and it was so UN,
And for many, many years, you know, the Korean engagement really totally went unrecognized.
Uh-huh.
And a large part of the victories that were won in battles in Korea were really attributed to the 65th Infantry, which and actually the unit, the 65th Infantry unit, was prepared and ready to go when the United Nations signed a decree soon after North Korea invaded the southern part of Korea.
Yeah, it was down in Busan. They were all bunched out on the bottom of Busan. They fought from
back
there.
Back in 1950.
Yeah, right, right.
And it was a United Nations fighting force, but the Puerto Rican Regiment of the 65th, they were a detachment of the United States Army, and they were right there front and center. They weren't battle tested because the Jim Crow laws of the United States of America didn't allow minorities or people of color to engage. The Army brass just didn't have enough confidence. And so just to even get the 65th engaged into Korea, it's quite a story.
Yeah, it is, the book, yeah.
That's in the book and that you could find over the internet, online resources, and it says that the unit was able to prove themselves under different NATO practices over there in the Caribbean. And then when the action began in Korea, well, they were the only unit that was sufficiently trained
and
ready to go.
And it's for that the United States has apologized recently, fulsomely, and in a correct way. We were wrong. And they should be honored rather than given vilified as they were. Is that no more or less correct?
And they fought valiantly in all the early battles that created the position. It was only until halfway towards the end when they needed a suicide squad to capture that hill, and the men were just had enough up until that point.
Yeah.
And you know,
confusion of language.
Yeah, the confusion of language, and also too just the. Just the reluctance at that point of those fighting men to just say, hey, wait a second, take it easy. And you know, some guys down from wherever they're from that make up the Army brass, and their great genius and their great determination of being hero worship, and well, it just didn't happen at all.
Yeah, right. But anyway, what happened is...
They were able to rescue, and they protected the flank of the Third Army and the retreat from the Chuan Reservoir. And for that is what they've achieved their greatness, because they were able to send the whole army.
Yeah, but there was this blow up with court martial and things like that, and there were people brought into the brig and all that kind of stuff. And it was something the United States had to apologize for.
Well, white America has always used minorities as scapegoats.
Well, that's true.
And so for every great incident in American history, they have to cheapen it by them blaming their dissatisfaction with the wrong guys.
Well, they made a mistake on that. They made a lot of it. We used to have a thing called slavery. That was a big mistake, and that held for a long time. But anyway,
well, a lot of American people didn't believe that at the time. So
I know.
It's only now when we reflect back on it.
But anyway, if I may, what happened is because a lot of those people that were sent back from Korea affect me, because I was drafted as an American. They had the draft.
As a Continental,
and there were a whole battalion. Is that like three companies? I don't know how it's done. I was part of a battalion that 1956-57 was sent en masse to Fort Henry Barracks at Calle in Puerto Rico.
Beautiful
to replace the people who had been ousted. And it was all Continental enlisted men, non-com Puerto Ricans and Continental officers at Fort Henry Barracks at Calle in 1956-57.
Yeah, after they developed the base as a country club.
Yeah, and that's the 60th.
They had the golf course, the pool.
That's where I used to swim. And there was the 65th Infantry that I was a part of.
Oh,
that's being now celebrated by President Obama.
Added to a long list of other achievements that the unit was able to...
And we have fulsomely apologized for having accused them of a lack of valor, which was not at all real. And we were apologized. They apologized to them. And now they're being honored.
Well, Indians, you can never accuse an Indian of not being valorous enough or courageous enough or brave enough. And so when those charges were brought, everyone in Puerto Rico knew that that was just throwing hay into the wind. And now... You know, many years later, our president, Barack Obama, in his God-driven ways, has helped to make the Congress recognize and the American people recognize the achievements of the 65th Infantry.
That was a huge representation of American leadership, as it were, political and economic.
Now,
Biden
leadership.
Was there. They were all there apologizing and giving the highest order of gratitude to the 65th Regiment,
part of the 65th.
I was brought in as a Continental, so I didn't do any fighting or anything like that.
So you came in afterwards as the rum and Coca-Cola unit of the 65th.
Something like that. But it was wonderful. It was just gorgeous. Calle is gorgeous, and Puerto Rico is gorgeous. I loved it. But all I did was swim on a swimming team. We won a medal.
Great.
Against the SAC base. Oh, five guys that were not very good soldiers.
Wait, and Ramey and I with Ija?
That was out of Abelgui. I think so. That's where we were. We had a thing we had to fight. It was hard scrabble. We just had five guys who weren't very well trained and We just won by the hair of our breath, the whole Antilles. It'll be in the record.
Wow.
They could look it up, a record.
Fabulous. Did you get a big medal?
I got a medal. They had a medal that they put on us, and we weren't very good soldiers, but we could just swim and everything. They put a medal where the whole damn battalion marched in review with the Gunner Bogey March and the band and all that, and pinned a medal, like Bo Jest on us for the medal. It was a beautiful day. Every day is a beautiful day in Calle.
Puerto Rico is paradise.
Columbus said
that when he first landed there.
But that was, I was a soldier there at that place at that particular time. So that's why I'm part of this, you know, the 65th, the Fighting 65th.
Well, we have
didn't do any fighting, but.
We have an honoring committee in East Harlem that wishes to rename a street corner.
Thank you.
After
I'm all
the
for
Borinqueneers.
It. 102, right?
Yeah, on 102nd Street on Lexington Avenue. It's a hill.
Uh-huh.
And it's something that we're really very proud of. The neighborhood and that particular location is made out of longtime Puerto Rican families, many who are related to the veterans of the 65th.
I think there should be recognition of the value.
I agree with you. And so
and
does the majority of the people
back.
That we've approached
they fought,
on this.
They fought valiantly in many wars. The First World War, Second World War, Korea,
you know,
they did.
It's always
they got
a good day.
Rap in Korea.
It's always a good idea to honor your veterans, your heroes, and the people that, you know, helped to bring up a community.
Yeah.
And in almost every instance amongst Puerto Rican families, like from the time that I was a kid up until today, is there's always a story that someone brings out about the valor of the 65th Borinqueneers.
I'm part of that gang. You know, I'm part of that. Now
I'm
a late Johnny
to have you
come
there.
Lately.
We
and I never fired
to have
anything
you
in anger
your,
or anything, but I'd like
activity.
To be associated and meet some of my fellows.
We're going
to
plan something.
But I want to give credit to the guys who really did the fighting, like you.
2016.
Or you were a ranger or something like that. You were a real soldier.
Well, I'm not old enough to be part of that unit.
Not that unit. No, but the Fighting 65th. Is the 65th thought of as a unit that really is synonymous with Puerto Rico? And their military?
Yeah.
So I'm part of that, right?
Am I
part of that?
I believe
so. Can I come to the ceremony?
You're going to be one of our invited very special guests.
Oh, right. I can't find my medal. It's there.
We're going to give you a medal that day.
And try and find it.
We hope to prepare some souvenir items.
We won by a hair.
For all veterans so that they could come to our event, which is planned for some time in 2016.
16. It's going to be next year, right? Okay.
Right next year. And, you know, we're going to have a nice thing. It's something that I think that the city and also, too, maybe even the Korean people from New York City might enjoy attending.
Sure.
You know, we're going to stress the element of peace.
Uh-huh.
You know, the greatest victories is one of peace and not of war.
Yeah.
You know, Waldo Emerson said that.
Yeah, right.
And it's something that I think that the people of New York City respect and would honor.
Yeah, I think it's a wonderful idea, and it gives tribute, and that they gave such an outpouring of that. It was the whole political establishment was there, and they were giving major support to this Puerto Rican initiative that was long overdue, and thank goodness, because they have this relationship that ought to be visited and so forth like that. So congratulations to you all, including myself.
Yes, Harold.
I was part of it.
Hey.
The 65th.
Do we have a video of that?
Maybe we could try to set that up. Now we're talking with Hernandez, and he's the chairman of this committee to set up a designated spot on 102 in Lexington here as part commemorating.
Well, no,
that.
Not really.
Here we go. Here is the president.
These bills do what we want all our laws to do, and that's serve the American people by honoring our past and building. Shortly after Puerto Rico became part of the United States in 1898, a regiment of Puerto Rican soldiers was formed, and they served our nation bravely ever since. In World War I, they defended the homeland and patrolled the Panama Canal Zone. In World War II, they fought in Europe. In Korea, they fought in mud and snow. They are the 65th Infantry Regiment, U.S. Army. They are also known as the Borinqueneers. I got to get this right. Borinqueneers, see? I practiced before I came out. They are from the Taino name for Puerto Rico, and segregation set them apart from their fellow soldiers, but their courage made them legendary. They earned thousands of medals for their service in Korea. Today, we're going to add to those accolades by awarding these soldiers one of the country's highest civilian honors, the Congressional Gold Medal. Only a handful of military units have ever received this award, and only one other Hispanic American has received this award, Roberto Clemente. That's pretty good company. So this is a proud day for the Borinqueneers and their families. It's a proud day for all those whose lives they saved and whose freedom they defended. It's a proud day for all Americans, especially Hispanic Americans who've made extraordinary contributions to our country, many through their military service.
Congratulations to the whole Puerto Rican community in recognizing that.
Thank you. I accept that.
That was only June 10th of this year. That only just happened.
It's current. It's current. It's something that's a long time and waiting, a long time and getting the action required to run it up to Washington.
All right.
And it was certainly something that everybody was in favor of. I know that with the committees working in East Harlem.
Everybody loves the idea.
Everybody loves what?
The idea of honoring the 65th Infantry
with a
street renaming ceremony up in East Harlem.
Whenever you talk
about the United States of America, you're really talking about a history of imperialism.
Yeah.
And Puerto Rico as a colony really doesn't much factor into that. I mean, we were just written into the body politic of the United States with a stroke of a pen in 1898.
Well, that was awful.
When Spain succeeded its right to the New World, to the
remember the Maine.
To the
Teddy Roosevelt, there was an apology on the part of the United States for having mistreated, if I may, our regiment. They gave them a bad rap. Because the problem was not with the unit that they had blamed and took the scapegoated that unit in to cover up bureaucratically or whatever mistakes that were made in Korea, gave them a bad rap, and they've apologized fulsome for having been wrong in that regard. I mean, it's another thing, because when you're conquering another people, then you're responsible. What you want to do is wipe that other culture out.
And steal their resources.
And take their resources.
And dominate their land.
And that's the history of the world.
Rape their women, kill their children. I mean, you know, it's pretty sad. The Indians, the Caribbean, did not have a word for the devil. And so when all of this came upon us like a ton of bricks, it was just something totally foreign to us.
Oh, absolutely. I know that's the case.
And the Chronicle state, Columbus recognized it early on that the people of the Caribbean were the people in God, in Dios. The word Indian really comes from the Spanish translation of in God, Dios.
Mm-hmm.
And that we were really very passive and peaceful, beautiful people. And that's the legacy that I carry with me. And the 65th Infantry, the fighting unit that was sent to Korea, proved that very valiantly. And for that, today, we wish to honor them with a street naming ceremony in Manhattan.
I think that's a wonderful idea, part of a thing that maybe will be part of a pattern of retribution or apology.
It's about time. I mean, it's something that's really very necessary, because if at some point the way that the world is going towards today is not stopped and shifted to a more equitable, sustainable model.
Thank you. It's just sustainable.
It's gonna exhaust the resources that it's running on today, and it's gonna be a terrible situation at that point. I mean, if you think things are bad now, can you imagine what'll happen?
You get the temperature up another few degrees Celsius.
Yeah, the icebergs begin to melt and the sea levels begin to rise. It starts to flood cities, low-lying cities.
That's becoming a major issue.
We lose
now. Right.
There are plenty of new technologies that we could explore.
Well, apparently there are. You know,
renewable resources that we could explore. Mumford wrote about that during the 60s with the myth of the machine.
Yeah, right.
The whole consciousness erasing you know, elements of great writers that have been sort of silenced.
Well,
if the Greeks didn't write about it as a tragedy, then the Romans did as a comedy.
Right, okay.
Because it's so preposterous. And then maybe people could see the humor in that.
Yeah.
Sido.
es la estrella que oculta la niebla. Hay paz en tu corazón. Más allá del reino y el dolor, brilla la luz del amor dentro de cada corazón.
Okay, wow, it was really good. I could go on and on. It's really beautiful. I love that Stand By Me and all the, and it was accurately recognizing the importance of the 65th, which I'm proud to be part of.
You're,
that was by accident.
You are a member of the 65th.
I'm,
and it's my pleasure.
One of the members of the 65th.
The post-Korean conflict, and I think that that says a lot. How part of what we're doing in East Harlem is to recognize that element, so that you know it's not forgotten.
Right, right.
There were men that were sent from a Caribbean hot climate, subtropical, to the freezing cold of Korea.
Yeah, right. It was. They fought really valiantly.
They fought their hearts out.
You're a Borinqueneer.
You're certified Borinqueneer.
Certified Borinqueneer.
You're certified Borinqueneer.
Okay. I hope it's in the record.
Did you learn any Spanish while you was in Puerto Rico?
Un poquitito. There was a thing about Barcelona. It was cha-cha-cha, que rico Barcelona.
Yeah.
What's Barcelona? I never knew what Barcelona meant, but there was a thing in Santurce. We'd go to Santurce. Barcelona, what does that mean?
I have
mean?
A friend of my friend, and he always says,
credits,
nacido a vacilar.
What does that mean?
Barcelona. I mean, Barcelona kind of guy is a free-spirited guy who has fun wherever he's at and makes the most out of whatever the situation
but
is.
But is responsible.
But is very responsible.
Like our guest.
Kind and caring.
Mr.
And
Hernandez.
As our host.
Oh, well.
A veteran of the
Mutual Admiration Fitcher. Society. Say goodnight. Say goodnight to the audience. The Fighting 65th.
The Fighting 65th. Yeah. Puerto Rico's Borinqueneers.
Please, tune in. Thank you for coming in. Thanks for coming in. Great thing. Give my best to all the gang. Looking forward to coming along at all the celebrations.
My absolute pleasure, Howard.
Yeah, pleasure. Okay, thanks for viewing. Thank you.